Here we see cells flowing through the bloodstream, but let's focus on this rolling macrophage that sticks to the endothelial cells that line the blood vessels by adhering to proteins. It's almost like molecular Velcro. The surface of the cell is remarkably dynamic, with membrane proteins that form connections with other cells and respond to external signals. If we flip across the membrane and look on the inside of the cell, we'll see this remarkable internal architecture made up of the cytoskeleton. It's very similar to the structural elements that's holding up the ceiling over your head, but unlike those structural elements, these are very dynamic. They assemble, and in this case, we're looking at an actin filament, or several actin filaments assembling, but they can also disassemble when other proteins sever those structural elements. Here we're looking at a microtubule, which is much more complex, but it too assembles and disassembles in some truly remarkable ways. These structural elements also serve as highways that motor proteins use to drag, for example, vesicles. These vesicles are full of proteins and other macromolecules that are distributed throughout the cytoplasm of the cell. Messenger RNAs are transported out of the nucleus and serve as templates for protein translation. So ribosomes assemble on these messenger RNAs, and as those proteins are made, some of them are free to float in the cytoplasm, while others bind to other proteins that help target them to organelles such as this mitochondrion that you're seeing right now. Still, other proteins are translated directly into other organelles like the endoplasmic reticulum. The endoplasmic reticulum releases vesicles, once again containing proteins and other macromolecules. So here we see the Golgi apparatus that's receiving vesicles and also releasing vesicles, some of which fuse with the plasma membrane and dump their cargo into the external environment, and also release transmembrane proteins into the plasma membrane. These proteins can change their shape dramatically in response to external signals. These changes in shape allow them to bind to other proteins, which in the case of this macrophage causes it to stop rolling, dramatically change shape, and squeeze in between two neighboring endothelial cells to go and fight infection in the tissue.